I welcome all of you in the another session of transportation engineering. So we have been discussing the segment number 3, that is railway transportation, and we have learnt about the role of railway. We have learnt about various aspects and components. Now in this session we are going to continue the segment 3, that is railway transportation itself, and in this session we are going to cover the topics such as ballast and track fittings. See, in last session we have covered sleepers. In this segment we are going to cover ballast and track fittings, and you are already briefly aware that what is ballast. If we discuss about ballast, then the ballast is a thing like this. You can observe certain aggregates, stones, mixture of sand, and you can observe in the photo that this is ballast. Now ballast is the layer of broken stones, gravel, sand, or any gritty material. It is laid and packed below and around the sleeper. You can observe that it is laid below sleeper and around sleeper. This particular material is used as an elastic cushion between sleeper and the top of the formation, and this particular cushion is called as ballast. Now, what are the requirements of good ballast? So first is that it should resist the crushing under dynamic loads. It should distribute the weight of passing trains on the formation under the particular layers uniformly. It should not make the track dusty. It should be reasonably elastic. It should have the resistance to abrasion and weathering. It should be durable. It should be non-porous, and it should be completely durable. It should hold the particular sleepers laterally and longitudinally under all the conditions, and it should able to facilitate the easy drainage of water so that the chances of accumulation of water on the railway track is quite less. Crushing, it should be well and adequate crushing strength. It should distribute the load. It should not make the track dusty. It should facilitate easy drainage. It should be non-porous. It should be durable. It should have the resistance of abrasion and weathering. It should hold the sleepers in all the conditions. And along with that, there are certain functions that we will have to learn of good ballast. Now, requirements means whenever we are choosing the material which will be used in ballast, how that material should be. And functions means once the ballast is placed, what are the uses of that ballast? This is the basic difference between the requirements and the functions. If we discuss about the functions, that first is that it provides the hard and level bed for the sleepers because it is laid below and around the sleeper. It holds the sleeper in the proper position during the moving trains. It provides some extent of elastic bed. It transmits the load. It protects the formation of products from the sunlight, rain and frost. It provides super elevation also some of the times because the slope is there and drainage is provided. It obstructs the growth of vegetation. So somehow you have to be clear that what you are going to write in the requirement section and whatever you are going to write in the function section, both are different things. Now, what are the various kind of ballast? The first is about the broken stone ballast. Broken stone ballast looks like this. The base material, it is the base and best material for railway tracks. It provides high interlocking, and due to that it helps to hold the sleepers with the particular ballast layer. As it is made up of broken stone, the stones that are going to be used are granite, quartzite, hard stones or limestone. Now the another is about the gravel. These are the gravel. They are obtained from the river beds or river pits or seashore. They are cheaper than broken stones. All the types that we have discussed, that is granite and quartzite. Gravels are quite cheaper than those. They are having excellent drainage property. They provide easy drainage, and it requires cleaning actually because it should not contain any kind of dust material in them. Then the third is about ashes and cinders. Now, it is the residue. It is the residue obtained once the coal is used in the locomotive. It is in the powder form. Sometimes it is in the form of what I can say, broken stones. It is having good drainage property. Corrosive property is also there. And it should not be used where the steel sleepers are used. because the particular holding will not be there. Then the another material is sand. Sand is the best material ever. It is having good drainage quality. It gives silent track. It reduces the noise pollution. And it is good for the packing of cast iron. So whenever steel is being used, if we are using steel, then we should not use ashes. If we are using cast iron, we must use sand. Then another material is murram. You might have also observed this thing whenever the road is constructed and it is on initial stage. Murram means it is the decomposed laterite rock. It is red in color. It is under the effect of heavy loads. It tends to get powder form. It is used in the siding and the embankment part. See, this is the railway track and this is how the embankment is there. Then it is used in the embankment part. So this is where the murram can be used. Then another is the kankars. This is found in the form of nodules of varying size, small size of stones or pieces. It is useful for meter gauge and narrow gauge track when the light traffic is there. Then comes the brick ballast. Brick ballast means the brick beds are used, the stones, the parts, the small parts of bricks are used. Overburnt bricks are used which cannot be used anywhere else. They are having good drainage property and they get converted into powder form whenever heavy traffic load is there and the tracks become dusty also. If we discuss about track fitting, then the first thing that you are observing over here is pantrol clip or elastic rail clip. It is the standard type of fastening used in IA. Fastening means which is used to fasten, which is used to fix. It requires less maintenance. Spring steel bar with the diameter of 20.6 mm is heat treated. It exerts the tow load of 710 kg with the deflection. Normal deflection which is allowable is 11.4 mm. It can be fitted to all the wooden kind of sleeper, cast iron sleeper and steel sleeper. And one of the disadvantages is that it can be taken out to using ordinary hammer, so it does not provide enough safeguard. That is the minus point. Pantrol grip, less maintenance, less safeguard can be used with any kind of, most of the kind of fittings, not any kind of fittings, except the tow load of 710 kg. Then let us discuss about fish plates. This is fish plate. Let me show you. See, these are the fish plates. You can see. And this is the rail chair. These are fish plates. See, you can observe four bolts. Why they are provided? Let me tell you that fish plates are used in the railway joints. They are used to maintain the continuity of the rails. See, it may happen that two rails are having joints. So to maintain that continuity, fish plates, see, this is one part, this is two part. So over this part, particular fish plate is provided, which allows the expansion and contraction in summer and winter season. What are the requirements? So it should maintain the correct alignment. The alignment should not be changed. It should support the underside of the rail and the top of the foot. It should provide proper space for expansion and contraction, as I have already narrated. It should be made up of any section which is able to withstand the shocks and heavy stresses and vertical bending moment. Various sections have been designed to bear stresses due to lateral vertical bending. These are the fish plates and this is the rail chair. Now the another is about spikes. See, a rail spike, these are the spike. They are also known as cut spike or cramper. It is the large nail with an offset at head, which is used to secure the rails and base plate to the railroad ties in the track. Spike is a kind of nail which is used to secure the rails and the base plate and should be tied on the track. It is used to hold the rails to the wooden sleeper. This is the nail, this is the nail, this is the rail and this is the sleeper. this rail and this sleeper are connected with each other with the help of spikes. And the good requirements of spikes are that it should be strong enough to hold the rail in position. It should be deep for better holding. It should be deep. It is having proper depth. It should be easy in fixing and removal, and it should be cheap in the cost. See, this is how it looks like. You can observe here, this is the head part, this is the depth. This is where it is used to get fixed with the help of hammer of any material. Various kind of spikes are there, such as dog spikes. Dog spikes are used to hold the FF rail to the wooden sleeper. The only minus point of this spike is there. Whenever the wave motion is there, there are chances of the spike that it can be driven out of the sleeper and the creep can be occurred. Dog spike, screw spike and round spike. These are the various kind of examples of spike sections. Then screw spike, as the name suggests, these are the tapered screw. You can observe over here. These are the tapered screw with V threaded. This is the V thread, which is used to fasten the rail with the timber sleeper. They are more stronger than dog spike, as you can observe that these are the threads which are provided over here. They are costly and the gauge maintenance is more difficult. Then round spike, they look like this. The head shape is either cylindrical or hemispherical. They are used to fix the chair to the wooden sleeper and also fixing slide chairs of the points and crossing. Then the standard spikes, they are used to hold the cast iron chair and fix them with the timber sleepers. And if we discuss about the elastic spikes, now the dog spikes can be eliminated with this. The plus point of this particular elastic spike is that it's this particular head. See, this is the head. The head absorbs the wave motion without getting loose, because you can see this, the head section is quite round in shape. It is not flat as dog spike. In the case of dog spike, there were the chances of driven out. An elastic spike, it can resist the wave action. Then comes the chairs and keys. The chairs, and this particular chairs I have already shown in the first figure how the chair looks like. They are required to hold the bull-headed rails and double-headed rails in the position. They are used to distribute the loads. They are having two jaws of the rail seat. The chair is fixed with the sleeper by means of, the chairs are fixed with the spikes. I will show once again. And the shape of the chair depends upon the type of rail used. See, this is the particular section of this. This is the example of chair. See, this particular chair is fixed with the sleeper by means of spike. This is the spike. And the shape of this chair depends upon the type of rail used. This is the fish plate, this is the chair. So this is also one of the examples. This is fish plate, this is the rail chair, and this is spike. See, this particular rail chair is clamped with this particular wooden sleeper with this particular spike. Fine. So this was all about track fitting and ballast. I hope you understood the concept thoroughly. Thank you so much.